the next song is actually somebody associated, actually has a song, a pretty big song, with our last artist.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Jelly Roll.
Oh, my God, we need Jelly Roll and Titty Swims.
Yeah, that would be nice. Or we could have, like, Jelly Roll, Big X the Plug, and Rick Ross and fuck shit up. Just the fucking triple entendre of those motherfuckers, bro.
Oh, my God, they should just make a Fat Cypher.
No, it should be You're the Biggest Loser. Oh, my God, play on words. It could be called My 600-Pound Life. I'm not making fun of him, by the way. I love Jelly Roll. I love Jelly Roll, and I love Big X the Plug. It's just not at all a slander for either of them. It's just, I'm actually thinking of a way they could play on that. And I feel like Jelly Roll would have found that funny. He come up with a funny song like that. I've heard the way Duke talks about it on podcasts, bro. Dude, you could come up with a banger like that. Also, I'm fat. Fuck you guys.
Fuck you guys. I'm going home.
I can say what I want. This is America. All right, Jelly Roll, Liar. Is this a new song, actually? Could just be a music video. Fuck it, we ball.
I let you drive around my mind.
Yeah.
I can't count the times you made me feel like I'm nothing. Played me like a fool, like a fool. Saying drink another whiskey, pop another pill.
Oh, this sounds familiar. I can feel.
I really like that guitar strum in the background.
Yeah,
though.
Like, I think, and he sounds nice, but I think. Oh fuck! Don't tell me Hardy wrote it. Don't tell me Hardy. We're gonna check this right now. It. Hold on, liar, Jelly. What? This is gonna be cool. Did Hardy help? Is Hardy a co-writer? I'm gonna laugh if so, cause I hear it immediately. I wonder if it's you want to know why?
Why?
You hear like the part where it comes in like this, where it's like.
Me like a fool.
This.
Like a fool, saying drink another whiskey, pop another pee.
Right. Okay. So now, if you go to a little song called "Jack" by Hardy, I could be tripping. Okay. You might listen to this and go, no, it's a stretch. But,
as a friend, I put have you ever
what?
I see they wanna sing. But if you stick with me, push it be wild. Don't listen to mama. Hell, I ain't.
It just reminds me of that. But later on in the song it comes in harder, like dun 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 dun.
It's just the tone.
Yeah. And then you have this, which comes in like this.
Saying drink another whiskey, pop another pee.
You hear it, right? It's just like the build up, the dun 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 dun, and the statements. It's not copied at all. It's just it's just really similar. Jack is a great song, by the way, by Hardy.
Anyway, it's a very, very basic rhythm though, as well.
Yeah, it's very
duh.
And I'm sure there's somebody that did it before Hardy that I just don't know. Yeah. But either way, the song Jelly Roll song does sound good right now. I didn't mean to throw it off like that. I wanted to give you an example.
Play me like a fool, like a fool. Saying drink another whiskey, pop another pill. Money makes you happy, heaven isn't real. You won't find nobody.
It's an interpolation.
Because your heart's too broke.
No, this part's
now
not.
I know you ain't nothing but a liar. Yeah, I walk right out the fire.
Hey.
Yeah, you try to keep me down, try to put me underground, but I'm only going higher. I can hear you in my head, in my bed when I'm dreaming. You try.
This sounds cold as fuck. This is really well done so far. I like this.
I'm not a fan of the chorus, I'm being honest. I don't know, it just doesn't hit. I love the verses, I love the pre-chorus, I love the whole build-up, but I'm just not the biggest fan of that chorus. I don't know what it is.
This was the theme of SummerSlam, by the way, I think. It was.
Like a devil in disguise, hiding your true colors. Just leave me alone. Keep leading me on.
Writing was a little weird there.
Love that production, man.
I love the production. That's the first thing I noticed. Vocal production, too.
Just the sound details in the background and stuff.
It'll be a grower course for you. Oh, I gotta pause it. I'm sorry. It's... You might disagree. You might agree about a lot of the things, but this could... I could really see this being like a... I heard snippets of this on SummerSlam. It didn't sound like this, but now I'm hearing it properly, and this sounds really good. I think that... This is... I've heard a lot of Jelly Roll songs. Other than, like, the main ones, like, his verse on Whiskey Bent with Cody Johnson was good. But, like, other than, like, his main big hits, this is the most I've liked a Jelly Roll song. Like, on first listen. Other than, like, the massive hits, like, Save Me and, you know, Son of a Sinner. And what's the last one? Oh, my God. Son of a Sinner, Save Me. Oh, God, you're not going to know, are you? It's more about God. I need a favor. Yeah, you try to keep me down, try to put me underground, but I'm only going higher. I can hear you in my head, in my bed when I'm dreaming. You try to be my friend, but you're blowing smoke. Holding now, I ain't scared of telling you where you can go. Cause I know. That old 80s build up right there. Skid Row. Okay, I gotta go back because we're about this. I just want to note that, like, Jelly Roll and Rag and Bone Man, could Dinesh just be the same person? You wouldn't know?
Yeah, no, it actually does remind me of, what human. Is it? Yeah, Human.
And they look the same, too, is the funny part. They look similar.
Yeah, like, the first thing when he's like, higher, it reminded me of the part of Human where it's like, higher, like, right before the final chorus. The bridge on that.
Which is funny.
It reminded me of. So, yeah, I don't know.
I was just saying because they look similar, but that's funny. Anyway. Here we go, choir. Yeah, walk right out the church choirs. Yeah, you try to keep me down, try to put me underground, but I'm only going higher. I can hear you in my head, in my bed when I'm dreaming. You try to be my friend, but you're blowing smoke. Hoping now I ain't scared of telling you where you can go. Cause I know you're nothing but a liar. It's also a little play here, because I don't know if it's intentional, but he's talking about all these bad things being put onto him, and he's talking about, like, try to put me on the ground, obviously, like, substance abuse and all that, but also he said, you're a devil in disguise, and he keeps calling him a liar, liar, and you're doing this, and he says, I'm not afraid to tell you where you can go. Well, what do people say when they say you can go somewhere? Usually they say you can go to hell. Yeah. So I think liar, and also liar, is literally what Jesus and multiple people in the Bible call, like, Satan throughout the Bible is liar. He's a liar. He's a liar. He's a liar. So I think that's actually the purpose of the song, that he's referring to Satan here. But I really like the song. It's written really... There's only, like, one little tiny part, but other than that, everything's written pretty well. It stays consistent. It works together. It has a cold little guitar solo. Has a little... Your obvious moment where it comes back in. Yeah, no complaints, pal. I have... Maybe just, like, the smoke line. The blowing smoke, maybe, line could have maybe been done again.
Here's the thing. The chorus, to me, is still, like, the weak point of the song, but it did grow on me on the second and third time around. For some reason, just didn't click the first time. And it still doesn't necessarily click. I still like the verses, the bridge and everything, the pre-chorus.
It'll grow.
I still like all of that better. I like the production under it as well, because they actually strip away that guitar strumming in the chorus, which I noticed, like, they'll have it playing throughout the verses and the build-up and everything, and then I'll strip it back and have the production got a little more basic around the chorus, which may have been to try and, like, put more focus on him and his vocal performance. I've seen, like, a lot of people want to, obviously, if you got dominant production, you don't want the most dominant vocals, and vice versa.
You also don't want to take, you just don't want to take, you also don't want to be too distracting during the chorus, because the vocals are doing a lot of the work. You don't want to, like, do too much shit, which usually people bring in all the shit in the chorus, though, which is the difference.
But then, you know, I really liked it, like, I wouldn't say it's a complaint. I wouldn't say there's anything particularly weak. I'd just say, like,
preference might fuck you.
It's more so a little bit, yeah. I mean, I just maybe wasn't a fan of how the first one came in, like, production-wise. I felt like the production got a little more basic.
Because I was hoping the production wouldn't, like, fuck it up.
But
I was hoping they didn't fuck the... I was like, come on, come on.
But especially the production on that second verse, like, the amount of details they brought in the background and everything, and... Yeah.
Really damn good. Yeah, look down here, top comment. Thank you, WWE, for introducing me to Jelly Roll. Yeah, because I don't know who he's friends with. He's friends with somebody in WWE. He's been involved in WWE twice, like, at two pay-per-views. And then at this one, they let him get, like, he got a chair and, like, hit somebody in the ring. Like, he fucked him up, too, bro. He killed that shit. I was watching it with my friends, and we were like, oh, my God, like, he looked like a professional. Like, he did it perfectly. Usually celebrities will come in, they'll have, like, celebrity guest star moments, and they'll, like, fuck up. But he fucking grabbed that chair and went, wham! Smacked the fuck out of him. And Jelly Roll killed that shit. A lot more athletic than I thought. They had to help his ass up, though. I did see that. When he fucking fell down, he did, like, a fucking, like, he did, like, the you can't see me shit John Cena on somebody. And he went to the ground, and they, like, started helping him up. He would have gotten up on his own, but they made him look... They were dickheads for doing that. No, but they fucking killed it, but then they used, for this one, they used his song as, like, the, every pay-per-view has a song. You see, yeah, Jelly Roll kicks up SummerSlam with the performance of Liar, yeah, so. But yeah, I don't know who he's connected to at the WWE, but they've gotten him so much promotion. Let us know what you thought about what we thought. If you like the video, leave a like. Comment down below, yep. Subscribe, we're almost at 1,000, we're so close. We're, like, a few hundred away now, we're trying to get there. We're fighting our hardest, if you don't, we're going to have to sell out and do a bunch of Benny videos. So please subscribe. I don't want to sell out. I don't want to go K-pop. Save me. No, I'm just kidding. Somebody save me. Me from K-pop. It's actually P-pop. Well, I got somebody save me. Me from getting canceled. All right, Dylan, thanks for you. Say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Bye, fellas.